thank the organizers. Yeah, let me thank the organizers for putting together this nice program and for inviting me to give a presentation. I'm going to talk about fractal quantum phase transitions, and this is a work done together with Zheng Zhou, who is an undergraduate student in Fudan University and spent some time, at least virtually, in my group last summer. Shifang Zheng, who is faculty at Chongqing, and in fact, Yizhi, who is the chairperson, and she was really the driving force behind this project. So the main question we were asking, addressing, is if we tune in some model that has spontaneous fractal symmetry breaking, such that we just cross a critical point to a paramagnetic phase. So we were asking, what are the properties of this quantum critical point? And first of all, if there is actually a quantum criticality, or just trying to get some concrete idea about this question. And for concreteness, we are studying the quantum triangular plaquette model, and the model is shown here. So the first term shown here is a plaquette term of the three sigma z operators, and this first term is acting on the downward pointing at triangles as shown here. And the first term, this plaquette term, has been introduced early on by Newman and Moore in the context of describing classical glasses in translation invariant settings. And this model has a ground state in which, for example, all spins are pointing upwards. And this state has now some interesting excitations. So, for example, we flip a spin, we just create three defects, and these defects can now be separated, and they can be separated in such a way that they are always at the corners of a Sierpinski triangle, as shown here. Now we add to this model a transverse field term. And now we want to understand the physics of this model, basically. And before I'm getting to simulating this model or to studying this model for the general case, I want to make some observations for this model. So first of all, this model this model does not have a simple Ising symmetry because we have an odd number of poly matrices in these terms, but it has a very peculiar Z2 sublattice symmetry. In particular, the Hamiltonian commutes with a term which is just a product of the sigma x on a Sierpinski gasket. Let me just demonstrate how this symmetry acts by looking at a specific case. So here we take the configuration, a spin configuration, which is a ground state of the plaquette term. So like all spins are pointing up. And now we just consider this on a lattice, on a torus with a dimension of some 2 to the n minus 1. And if we now pick a subset of spins on the Sierpinski gasket, as I mentioned earlier, so in particular those which are highlighted here, and we flip all these spins, we get now another ground state. Right? So in fact, we find that there are, for this particular geometry, that there is the number of independent generators increases linearly with system size. So we find that there's actually a sub-extensive ground state degeneracy of this model on this particular lattice. So this is the first observation, so that we have a model with a peculiar Z2 sublattice symmetry. And a second observation is that this model has a Kramers Vanya type self-duality. So we can go to some dual variables for describing that live on these triangles, and then we can show that this model is in fact self-dual. So what have we learned so far? So we have now a model with our tuning parameter, and if this transverse field is zero, so we only have this plaquette term, then we have a system where the ground state spontaneously breaks this sublattice symmetry. So on a given Sierpinski gasket, for example, we find that all spins have to point in the same direction. And for large gamma, the ground state is a simple paramagnetic state, symmetric state. And we know that if there is a critical point, it would have to be at one because of this self-duality. And this is now exactly what we want to understand better. So what's actually happening as we tune through this phase diagram? And in order to answer this question, we use Monte Carlo simulations using the stochastic series expansion and first calculate a many-body correlator. And the many-body correlator is chosen in such a way that it exactly characterizes this sublattice symmetry breaking. So in particular, there's some recursive way of defining this many-body correlator. So it basically just includes SC operators on the corners of the of this Sierpinski triangle. For if R, like basically the size of this Sierpinski triangle is in 2 to the n, where n is a natural number, then the many-body correlator reduces to a three-body correlator on the corners of this triangle. So, and this expectation value is then finite in the phase with spontaneous symmetry breaking of this fractal symmetry, and it is zero in the paramagnetic phase. So this many-body correlator nicely separates these two phases. And this is basically shown here. And then we see that depending on, as I just pointed out, so basically depending on R, we have a different number of, or the number of non-trivial operators in this many-body correlator differs. And we find that indeed in the symmetry broken phase, that the expectation value then goes to zero with the number of non-trivial operators. And for a fixed number of operators, it just approaches a constant with respect to the size of this Sierpinski triangle. While in the symmetry broken phase, it goes to zero exponentially, well, with a stretched exponential. And D here is actually the fractal dimension of the Sierpinski triangle. So basically, we have now a many-body correlator that detects a spontaneous symmetry breaking of this model. And to understand the phase transition better, we look at an order parameter. And again, the order parameter is based on this on this correlator, so on this kind of recursively defined correlator. And for this, on one hand, we just plot this order parameter, and we see that here for different sizes, that it scales to zero in the paramagnetic phase, and it goes to a finite value in the phase with fractal symmetry breaking. And moreover, we calculate for this specific order parameter the Binder cumulant, and we find that the Binder cumulants cross at the critical point of gamma equals to one, and that it already indicates that this is a continuous phase transition. And moreover, we are looking at the histograms of the order parameter, and we find that there's no double peak structure, which again is indicative, or basically just take as an evidence for this being a continuous phase transition. So what we take away from this is that that we have here quantum critical point separating a phase with spontaneously broken fractal symmetry and a paramagnetic phase. And at last, I want to show some results for the scaling behavior at the critical point. So now we tune to the quantum critical point, and we look at two-point correlation functions. And these are basically the energy terms. So we have the sigma x, and we have the triangular terms like tau x. Tau x is a dual variable corresponding now to a product of three sigma z's as written in the Hamiltonian. So, and what we find is that there's an algebraic decay of these correlations at the quantum critical point, and it actually goes to zero algebraically with a fractal scaling dimension, and the fractal scaling dimension exactly corresponds to the dimension of the Sapienski triangle, like so log 3 over log 2. And in fact, the reason for this fractal scaling dimension is due to some sort of rough low energy configurations in this field theory that each derived for this model. So the simple Gaussian theory indeed can predict this scaling behavior with the fractal dimension of the Sapienski triangle. So let me conclude. So we have looked now at a specific model, namely the triangular Plakot model, which exhibits a phase transition between a phase with spontaneous fractal symmetry breaking for small transverse fields and a paramagnetic phase for large transverse fields. And these two phases we find are separated by a continuous quantum phase transition. And this quantum critical point is described by some fractal scaling dimension. Good. Let me now conclude then by thanking my collaborators for this very nice collaboration, and thank you for your attention.